And the ball stolen there by Shy McClellan. Here comes McClellan on a breakaway. He'll go in and then jam it with some elevation.
Start a riot tonight, a black alliance tonight. In this world, he who stops won't get anything he wants. Play like the top 1% till nothing's left to be spent. We don't care, we won't stop. Call your mothers, call the cops. We are the champions, setting it all forget. Oh, we on fire, we on fire.
Firestorm fans, welcome to Firestorm Chat. We are here for what should be an exciting day of talking about basketball, basketball, and basketball. We'll be joined by the head coaches from our basketball programs here at Arizona Christian. Jeff Rutter here in screen with me, and head coach Barry from women's basketball will join us here in just a little bit. But we're here for Firestorm Chat, our first of hopefully many opportunities to get you talking to the coaches and getting you more familiar with our teams and more familiar with our coaches. So, Coach Rutter, thanks for joining us here on Firestorm Chat. As we get started, it's been a season where people had a lot of doubts about your team is because you turned so many people over. You lost like five of your top six scorers, but the one guy you do have back is Chris Sterling. What has Chris Sterling done for your program in the 2 years he's been part of it?
Well, I think he keeps getting better and better. He's been battling some injuries this year. So I think that slowed him down in some other areas, but he's really shot the ball very well. He's starting to really rebound well. He's improving defensively. So I think he's going to be one of the better players in the conference this year. And our conference is good enough. That means he'll be one of the better players nationally as well.
Well, of course, he earned all-conference honors and NAI honorable mention, All-American honorable mention. And so everybody knows about him. But he was the one piece that was coming back. People picked you to finish fifth in the conference, actually. What are your thoughts on how that's getting ready to play out? You have Benedictine, you have Masters. How is your team ready for this upcoming conference schedule?
Yeah, I think, you know, if you look at the whole GSAC and the preseason poll, really difficult to do. Really, Biola and Westmont have lots of people back from good teams, so I think they're the clear-cut, you know, safest picks. And then there hasn't been a real challenging schedule from – played by most teams. I think we still have five or six teams undefeated. And December, a couple conference games and lots of more competitive tournaments for a lot of the teams. So I still think it's probably as murky as it was preseason poll time on who's where. I do know that everybody's very good, and a lot of the teams that finished near the bottom last year have improved quite a bit. And I, you know, like most years in the GSAC, anybody can beat anybody on a given night. So that I think our preseason focus has been get ready for that kind of grind and needing to learn how to win when we don't shoot our best and don't play our best, where we're still able to defend and rebound and do some of those things that we can control.
The great recruiting things you did this year was you brought in a guy named Shy McClellan, and he's done a fantastic job running your team from point guard. He's second on scoring, he's up in rebounding, he's leading in assist. Talk about how you got him here and what you did to make him just immediately just run your team and everybody kind of gelled around him.
Yeah, Shai's been great. He played at Mesa Community College locally here, and we were aware of him then and talked to him then, knowing he would go Division I. But, you know, we always try to plant that. If it doesn't work out, you know, keep us in mind kind of thing. So he went to Division I and was among their best players in among the best point guards in that conference. And it wasn't a great fit for him. And he wanted to come back home to what's kind of his new home in Arizona. And so we're fortunate to have him. He's a guy that doesn't need to score to really, really impact the game and kind of take over the game. I think that was he has the ability to score, as we saw in our last game against Trinity International, where I think he had 20-something in the second half and kind of got us going. But, you know, he brings a steadiness to us. We don't turn the ball over very much as a team. He gets us in our stuff. He's really hard to pressure. So it's comforting to have somebody who, you know, has the ball in their hands a lot that that really doesn't get rattled. He's as competitive and tough as a player I've been around, and I, you know, that rubs off on our team as well. But he's a guy that does so many things that can help you win. Defending, rebounding, and taking care of the ball, makes real good decisions. Just really doing a good all around job of running our team.
One of the things you've also implemented this year, and Shy McMullen so far has that title. It's the, you call it the tough, smart, unselfish belt. Tell me about that. Where did that come from? Right there.
Yeah, we made a championship belt out of this year. Tough, smart, and unselfish has been the real core values of our program, what we're trying to be individually and as a group. So we just tried to bring a fun way to highlight that. So last year it was hard hats, and we've just tried to have some creative things each year. So basically we want to highlight, particularly in the preseason, but we carry it on all year, highlight the little things that kind of help you win a game that don't always show up in a box score or that you don't get a lot of glory for. So things like deflections and taking charges and getting on the floor and those little things. So it's been good. It's been we just talked about Shy. He's kind of jumped out to pretty big lead. He has so many positives that he does, you know, each minute he's on the court, that jumped out to a big lead. But guys like Matt Wilcom and Andy and Steven Laux, guys that don't make a lot of mistakes, are kind of climbing back into it. So it's not over yet, but Shai's got a pretty good lead starting off there.
One of the things that's always impressed me about Shy is his ability to rebound. I mean, he's not the tallest guy on the court. He's maybe one of the fastest on the court, but he seems to have a great knack for being in the right place at the right time to rebound the ball. Is that part of this getting the belt, and is that the things that you're seeing that allowed him to get that belt and allow him to rebound? I mean, he's just there rebounding all the time.
Yeah, I think he's got a nose for that and a real knack for where the ball's going to be, and he's pretty aggressive going after it. So if it's in his area, he's, you know, regardless of size, he's got a good chance to get it. You know, I think it, he's a natural for the TSU, the stuff that it's about. There's others that those things don't, you know, they guys tend to focus on scoring, particularly if you're not, you know, maybe playing the role you want. You tend to feel like if I scored more, I might get a chance to start or play a little bit more. So really designed to highlight those things, that to let guys know, you know, scoring is great, and we need to be able to score. We recruit guys that can score. That's just kind of to be in our program. We expect you to be able to put the ball in the basket. But to increase your role and to stay on the court on a bad shooting night, you need to be able to do those other things. So Shy's a natural dad. He gets deflections every 20, 30 seconds. He's got his hand on the ball somewhere. And so he eats up those points there. But we really just want to highlight that your identity is not in scoring and putting the ball in the basket, that our identity is with defense and rebounding and toughness and hustle and those types of things.
You've mixed all that together so far, and you're 4-0 as far as games played that actually count for you. You've played a couple of exhibitions, played some Division I, some Division IIs. What have you gotten out of the first 7 games you've played this season going forward as you prepare for conference?
Well, I think we've been getting better and better. And I think most encouraging thing to me with this early schedule, you know, we wanted some tough games on the road. And so we were able to get a couple Division I games on the road. And the difference from our game at New Mexico State to our game against Montana State, just really in a week or two, but totally different mindset and quite a bit of improvement. New Mexico State, a lot of adversity early on, lots of foul trouble, some injuries, and it snowballed into a 50-point defeat. And we know they're not 50 points better than us, but it just kind of snowballed. And to be honest, we didn't always handle it the right way coming off the court, you know, after the game in the locker room, those sorts of things. Talked a lot about it, worked on some of those responses to adversity the week after. And then Montana State, similar type thing. We played pretty well, and we're really tightly in the game. Had another stretch, 12-minute stretch, where they took 25 free throws and we took four, and had a couple guys cramp in, a couple injuries. And so, again, a lot of adversity on the road against a Division I opponent, but the response was totally different. And there was no drop in, you know, while frustrated with circumstances, there was no drop in energy or attitude or guys encouraging each other. And it was very, very positive. So that's a tremendous sign of growth and really us being out here in Arizona, winning on the road is the difference between, you know, winning a conference title and finishing third or fourth. And so that's kind of what we're really focused on, is the mental approach to playing on the road and responding to adversity in a positive way as a team. So, and I think we're headed down the right path.
Next up on your schedule is a meeting with Benedictine. You've played them once this season already. You beat them by 50 points, but you and all of your coaching staff and any player I've talked to said that was kind of a mirage, kind of. They're a lot better than a 50-point game against us, and they were missing a key player. You have them on your schedule right before you go to conference. What are you expecting in that matchup with Benedictine?
Well, just like New Mexico State wasn't 50 points better than us, it was really a similar type of game. We made some shots early. They missed some easy stuff that they normally make, and they got in some foul trouble, and it just kind of snowballed into looking worse than it really was. So I think our guys are mature enough to know that. We, you know, being in town, we know a lot of the same guys, and our guys, you know, play some open gyms with them, so we know how talented they are, and they're a good program. They added Kincaid, and he's played very well for them, played real well against Trinity International. And what he really brings to them is another level of quickness and athleticism, and a guy that can get in the key, and a guy you got to pay a lot of attention to defensively. Similar to Shai, Kincaid doesn't need to score to impact the game, just getting in the key and getting some of their really good shooters open and delivering the ball to some of their really good post players can have a big impact on the game. So it's a totally different game. Again, it's on the road, and you don't typically shoot quite as well as you do at home, and expect them to have a pretty good crowd and some things. So there's a totally different game, and you don't get to carry over the points from the last game, unfortunately. So we're starting from scratch there, and it presents a new challenge, which we're excited to have a good challenge on the road heading into conference play.
Well, one thing I know that you're going to be facing is they're having ugly sweater day at the game on when you come to town. So be prepared to see a lot of ugly Christmas sweaters.
I might need to bust out my ugly
sweaters. Maybe bring your own. So that will be. I know they're trying to hype that up, kind of like we do an all-in game. They're hyping that up with an ugly sweater thing, or wear a Christmas beanie or something like that. So you're going to see a lot of Christmas colors there. Immediately following that, on Saturday, you get to take on the Masters College. That opens conference play, Golden State Athletic Conference play. Again, you're picked fifth in the preseason poll. What do you think about Masters? They got a new coach. They got a lot of new talent as well. They may be kind of a sleeper in the conference. What are you thinking about them coming up?
Yeah, they got a new coach, but he's a GSAC veteran, had a lot of success in the GSAC, so he's not really new to the league. And we know a lot of their guys too, and we're recruiting some of them. They're very talented. They, on paper, they may be the best offensive team in the league right now. And similar to us, they've got several blowout wins, and then played some really good teams in exhibitions, and didn't win those, but they've played good competition, and they'll be ready to go. They're averaging 100, 102 points or something so far this year, and they can put points on the board very quickly. They're young, so I expect them to keep getting better and better as well. So it'll be an interesting one. I think, they weren't picked real high in the conference, but I think they're in that mix of teams right at the top that have a chance to, finish anywhere from first to fifth and can beat anybody on a given night. And, I expect them to be very good, and it's a tough one to open conference with, but we're looking forward to getting into conference.
So what I'm hearing you say is you're bringing your track shoes, and we don't need a shot clock for your game against Masters, because you guys are just going to try and outscore each other, for lack of a better term.
Well,
defense may be a key at some point.
Yeah, we're going to try to slow them down and still play our game offensively, but we'll see how that goes.
Well, I've seen you guys play enough that I know you guys like to get up and down the court too, especially when you have guys like Shai and Chris Sterling that get the ball in their hands and let it fly. So, Coach, as you're looking at in your season, what kind of things are you still hoping to, like, oh, that's the one area we have to improve on?
Well, we got a lot of things we got to improve on. And I what excites me about our team is we are a team that values hard work and practice and knows that we don't have it all figured out right now. And I see a lot of upside in our team. We're going to be, you know, I think we're a good team right now. We're going to be much, much better in February than we are right now. We're going to keep getting better and better. Defensively, we still, you know, we want to be a team that's pressuring the ball and getting after people, but a tremendous help side team. And we're pretty good in stretches. But the consistency, you know, is going to be a process all year long of getting better and better. Some guys are very good at that, and others, you know, that are good players aren't communicating like they need to. And so as a unit, that's an area of growth. Defensive rebounding, I think, hasn't been as good as it should be to this point in the year. Now, we've done a nice job defending shooters, and there's been a lot of misses against us. Teams haven't shot a real good field goal percentage, so there's a lot of opportunity for defensive rebounds, but percentage of those, we haven't got to the point where we need to. So that's another habit that needs to continue to develop with some guys, that we can tend to get into a jumping contest for rebounds at times when we need to be a bit more physical. On the offensive end, I love how unselfish this group is. That very willing to make the extra pass, and you don't see guys caring who scores, just as long as ACU scores. And so that's a good thing to build on. Spacing and our timing need to continue to get better. And when we do that, you know, the Shies and Chris's that can create a little bit, we'll have a little more room to work. And we got a number of tremendous shooters on our team, that the better spaced we are and the more that a Shy is able to get into the key, then the more a Matt and a Welcome and Al Brown and Jason Smar and Andy and so many guys that can put the ball in the basket from the perimeter, those guys will just get better and better. So those are all the areas we're kind of focused on daily, and we've made strides in the last few weeks. Thought we had a real good week of practice this week, but I expect that to be a season-long journey of getting better in those areas.
Well, we're on Firestorm Chat, and we're talking with head coach Jeff Rutter. And, Coach, we thank you for taking the time to sit down with us and give us a little talk about your team and where you're going, and we're excited for the season. And you're also closing in on a little thing called 100 wins, and I know that's probably not even on your radar, but for everybody else it's kind of a big deal. You're getting to 100 wins here hopefully pretty quickly. I think you're about 5 wins away from that. So, Coach, good luck as we head into a tough game against Benedictine, and then Golden State Athletic Conference opens up on Saturday. Coach, thanks for your time.
All right. Thanks, Tim. I'm going back to my roots another day, another door, another high, another door.
Welcome back to Firestorm Chat. I'm joined by head coach Odell Berry, head women's basketball coach here at Arizona Christian University. Coach, thanks for spending the time to talk with us and give us a little bit about what you've learned about your team so far to start this campaign.
Well, I think probably the number one thing I've learned about them is they want to win. And they're very competitive, and they want to get after it every night. And so from that perspective, they're going to drive themselves to do better. And that seems to be taking place every day of practice. It's taking place in the ball games. They're learning a lot as they go every day. We obviously have a lot of new faces. We brought back 3 kids who had a lot of minutes last year, and everybody else that's contributing this year, you know, they're all basically new. And so they're learning a little about our philosophies. They're learning about what we try to do and accomplish on the court. And so it takes a little while for them to learn those things. It takes a little while for them to begin to gel and to figure out how to most effectively use each other's abilities and skills. And so because they want to win, they're pushing hard toward that goal.
Well, Coach, when you set up your schedule, you set up what turned out to be a couple of teams that were not so challenging, and a couple of teams that probably proved a lot of challenge for your team, especially when you come to talking about your depth. But You've played against Benedictine, and you've had some good success against them. What have you learned in your victories and your successes on the things that are really strong about your team? You talked about winning, getting wanting to win, but what have you learned that, okay, that's really working well?
I mean, you know, obviously, if you look at the stats, offensively, we can put the ball in the basket. We can score some points. At the same time, probably one of the things that I've been least encouraged about has been our defensive effort at some points. And some of it has to do with not fully understanding or grasping the concepts that we're trying to put in place. And some of it is, you know, they're younger players and they've never played defense like this before. They've never been challenged by offensive teams like we see in our conference and in our non-conference schedule. So when you talk about Benedictine, they're an excellent offensive team. They have several very good scorers. They have a good offensive approach to the game. And so if we don't play our best defense, if we don't get out there and hit the boards and do the things that I think we have to do to be successful, we struggle a little bit. And so, you know, we play Benedictine. They've scored probably more points than we'd like to allow the other team to put on the board. And so that's part of the learning process, is to see, you know, what we can learn each day in practice, what we can do to get better to help reduce the number of points that we give up.
Well, Coach, you talked about, I think, one of the biggest keys for your team is you are young. You have really one senior on your team. You have a couple of juniors on your team, but primarily you're a sophomore-driven team.
Mm-hmm.
Starts with Courtney Christmas, returning player for you, a sophomore, leading your team in scoring, leading your team in rebounding, you know, kind of the team leader overall. What does Courtney Christmas bring to your team?
You know, the youth that you talk about, I think, is a real key to what's happening in our program right now. Last year was a good year for some of those kids to come out of high school and see what the college game is a little bit about. This year in the off season, you know, there's no question that especially the sophomores that are coming back really worked hard. They worked hard in the weight room. They worked hard on the court to improve their skills, their ball handling, their shooting, and so forth. And that's starting to pay off, and they're seeing that it pays off. If you do the work, you know, you're going to be able to see the benefits. And so some of those kids are really beginning to see those benefits. Courtney, you know, I see my sophomores come back this year, and they walk in the gym, and to me they just look bigger and stronger and smarter than they were last year, and that's part of the developmental process. That's exciting to think about what they're going to be next year as juniors, next year as seniors. We got to focus on this year, but the kids that we have on board, the new recruits that we've brought in this year who are going to be back with us, and kids who are coming next year are all things that are just going to help continue to improve the program.
Well, some of your best recruits this year have been Courtney Leach, mentioned a senior, and then you have Susie Castro-Larson, and you also have Tony Davis. Mm-hmm. Tell me about how those three have kind of come in and helped gel your program.
Well, I think, you know, when you talk about any time new players come into a program, they all come in with their own expectations, and they come in with what they think they're going to bring to the program. I think they've all three of those kids that you've mentioned have been very open to fitting into the program. They're not here to do their own thing. They're here to be a part of our program. And so they've all worked hard to sort of have that team feel on and off the court. They've worked hard to you know, pick up what we're looking to do offensively, defensively, and so forth. And so, you know, obviously Courtney Leach, senior, a lot of experience, played in a good conference where she played in the past. You know, she just brought a little extra experience that we really needed this year. Susie Castro-Larson, again, coming from the JUCO level in California, you know, they have some good basketball over there, and she's played against good competition. She's continuing to develop. I mean, I see her getting better as we go through practices on a daily basis. And you mentioned Tony. Tony Davis is a freshman. She has a lot of physical attributes. She's still learning a lot of things about the game and a lot of things that we're trying to teach her. But she's an exciting player to watch. And as long as we can harness all that energy and put it in the direction that we want to go, then she's gonna help us a lot.
I don't think she's ever met a shot she's not willing to take, that's for sure. And you, as you talked about, you got to get them ironed in on defense a little bit better. You're starting a conference schedule, and it's no easy task to take on the Golden State Athletic Conference. And you open with a team that's usually ranked in the top 10 or 15, the Masters College. They tend to be kind of big and shoot from everywhere, and, you know, you open with them. What are your thoughts on taking on the Masters on Saturday?
You know, one of the things that we've done this year and that I try to do most years is the non-conference schedule. You know, I get a little static from my coaches sometimes because they want us to pile up some wins. But I really think it's important that your team understands that they can compete at a high level. And so, you know, for example, basically four out of our last five games have been against teams that are, you know, top 25 teams. And so, we've competed very well for the most part against those teams. We've been right in the ball game. Thought we had a chance to win at least two out of the four, and the other couple slipped away when we got into foul trouble. Had issues with our depth and things like that. But certainly, with our top five, six, seven kids, we're out there competing with teams who are at the top level. So, coming into the GSAC. You know, we know that those are some good teams too, but we've had some experience playing good teams, and we've learned some things from playing those teams, and I think it's going to help our girls feel a little more confident about stepping into the arena with some teams who are, you know, highly ranked or teams who are supposed to maybe win our conference, those kinds of things, because they feel like they can compete at that level. They feel like they're right there with them.
The good news is you get them at home, and hopefully you can use a little bit of the Fultz Memorial Gym mantra to just drive you to a win.
I mean, the worst part about having the game on the 10th is that school's already out. And so, you know, we love to have the gym packed. We love to have the kids in here yelling and screaming, bringing the energy. So hopefully some people will be hanging around and come back and be a part of that game. That certainly is a big help to us to have people in the gym.
Well, Coach, we thank you for taking the time to join us here on Firestorm Chat, and we wish you the best of luck throughout your season, and we'll have you back on again, and we'll catch up with you to see how things are going. Coach, thanks for your time.
Thanks, Tim.
Let's go out and get some W's.
All right, Coach. Let's do it.
You've been listening to Firestorm Chat, and thanks for joining us. I'm your host, Tim Gooszen. For everybody, Coach Barry, Coach Rutter, and our producer, Candler Harris. Thank you for tuning in and listening to Firestorm Chat. We'll talk to you next time.
Let's start a riot tonight, a pack alliance tonight. In this world, he who stops won't get anything he wants. Play like the top 1% till nothing's left to be spent. We don't care, we won't stop. Call your mothers, call the cops. We are the champs.